All right, similar to the vendor list, vendor type list, and customer type list, we also have a job type list. To get to the job type list, you come up here under customers, move on over to your job type list. It's a free type box that you create, so when you come up here and you say new for a new job type, you can come in here and say new job type. You can make it a sub-account of another type if you want to. Most of the time I only see headers for job types, but it's a possibility. All right, so if new construction and remodel were the two types and you had remodel extension and then you also needed to do new construction extensions, you could do that. All right, so you can do subs. The job types, where you enter them in, is in the customer center here. When you double click on the customer, notice you don't have the job information tab over here. When you go into a job though, double click on it, you have your job info tab. Okay. Under the job info tab here, you have your job type. Here is my new job type, so I can choose this one. All right. Some reasons why this is a great feature. Again, when you run your reports, you can run a report for customer contact list, customer phone list, and you can modify this report and filter it by job type. Job status, job type, there we go. So you could run a report for all job type new construction. Gives me that list. Here are the people I want to call because I have a promotion going on about new construction. So it's a great way to, again, filter down your lists. It's also a great way to be able to run reports so you can run a profit and loss standard, modify it, filter it for all job type. There we go. For all job type remodels. Okay. Tells me for all jobs that I classified as remodels, here's my profit and loss for that. It's a great way, again, to segregate out your business, to be able to run reports to see which areas of your business are the most profitable.